Welcome you all to week 7 of the business finance นะครับ I hope you all fine with your family นะครับ and COVID is still around here นะครับ so stay safe and take care everyone นะครับ let's continue our story with the business finance นะครับ and today we're gonna finalize what we call ratio analysis นะครับ after that we're gonna discuss about the next chapter นะครับ that is called time value of money นะครับ before we move on นะครับ if you are ready นะครับ please type 1 in our line group นะครับ so I know that you are always here นะครับ and ready นะครับI'm very very happy to meet you today นะครับ and I hope that you feel the same นะครับ some of you นะครับ some of you drop me a message นะครับ I hope that I get back to you on time นะครับ some of you have a question นะครับ so today นะครับ I have prepared นะครับ example of the financial statement analysis นะครับ we are going to discuss about this as an example at the beginning of the classAfter that, we're gonna continue our discussion on our lesson. นะครับ during the week, นะครับ I got some question. อาจารย์ when you deliver in the class, that is quite simple. But when we download the financial statement, oh my god, there are a lot of item. นะครับHold on, นะครับ no worry, นะครับ I'm here to support you, นะครับ So some of you send me a message, นะครับ during the day, นะครับ If I am free, I get back to you on that time, นะครับ Some of you send to me like 10 p.m. If I didn't go to bed yet, นะครับ I get back to you, นะครับ Okay, นะครับ So first of all, นะครับ greetings and welcome, นะครับ of, นะครับ Fari Arm F องศาคันจินักขิงบุญนะครับปาล์มปายมันเดย์ดีดีเคสนะครับเบิร์นฟรีนะครับเดอะฟอร์ดจีลุยเจนเยลลี่เจมส์ใบบัวมิลค์จ๋ากังฟูปูเป้แอนทีนะครับ thank you so much นะครับ thank you so much for your participation นะครับ I hope you are all happy นะครับ and I hope that you stay safe and take care นะครับI got a few questions นะครับ one the first question นะครับอาจารย์ when I see in the real financial statement there are a lot of item how we gonna deal with that นะครับ and the second question is that how we gonna find out that financial statement นะครับ that's why if you remember นะครับ I download the financial statement and put it on the Google Drive นะครับ I put it on the Google Drive นะครับ soI try to assist you นะครับ as much as I can นะครับ so today นะครับ I have prepared example นะครับ example นะครับ so I choose the company that we didn't choose it for the term projects นะครับ and I do some financial analysis for you นะครับ so let's have a look here นะครับ I will share this file to you นะครับ after the class นะครับ during the break นะครับSo here is a company called Synnex นะครับ they sell electronic นะครับ and digital equipment โอเคนะครับ if you have a look here นะครับ this is the real financial statement นะครับ I remember when I worked in the corporation as a financial analyst as a corporate finance managers we try to make an analysis about this to understand the performance of our company as well as the performance of our competitors นะครับ if you have a look here you seeStatement of financial position นะครับ Sometimes they use the word balance sheet นะครับ Here is statement of comprehensive income นะครับ Actually that is a income statement or profit and loss statement โอเคนะครับ Have a look here นะครับ Another question is that อาจารย์ we should use consolidate or we should use separate นะครับ You should use consolidate.นะครับ why นะครับ basically this company they have subsidiary so the important thing is that you need to use the consolidate นะครับ because it console all of their subsidiary already โอเคนะครับ this is what we call consolidate นะครับ the financial skill that we discuss in this class นะครับ if you understand all about this นะครับ I'm sure you can get a good job you can be if even you are the business owner นะครับ you understand about the financial statement of your company and you can project your financial statement นะครับ this is important นะครับ but finance is not just like this นะครับ we have advanced math we have advanced calculation นะครับ but finance is different from other subject if you calculate based on these numbers basically we arrive at the same answer โอเคนะครับ so have a look hereอาจารย์ oh I have a look here there are a lot of item how we gonna apply on our own นะครับ let's have a look นะครับ so I ask you to do liquidity ratio working capital gearing and profitability just these four โอเคนะครับ the first one current ratio you use current asset divided by current liabilityOkay, นะครับ this is the first one. The second one is the quick ratio, current asset minus inventory divided by current liability. Okay, นะครับ The third one is the cash ratio. You use cash divided by total current liability. นะครับ The fourth one is the net working capital to total asset. If you rememberWorking capital is mean current asset minus by current liability and divided by current total asset. Okay, นะครับ So we practice from the real case. นะครับ Whether you go in the future, นะครับ financial statement is also important. นะครับ Some of my students they go for the master degree. They told me, อาจารย์วัสสุ we still use your template because that is exactly the same thing. นะครับ You see.So save this template with you นะครับ it is not just benefit to you just in this subject นะครับ later on we discuss about the working capital we discuss about the cash conversion cycle นะครับ so the first one is the inventory conversion you see you use average inventory and divided by you see here PL C15 what is that C 15 is total cost okay นะครับ that is your link นะครับ so here is your inventory conversion you do the same thing as the receivable payable and then a plus b minus c is the cash conversion cycle that's it okay นะครับ later on in the break in, during the break I will share you this calculation ครับWe also discuss about the gearing ratio. What is that? Total non-current liability or long-term debt divided by this one plus total equity. Just that. Okay, นะครับ You see my formula. นะครับ And finally, today we are going to discuss about the gross profit margin, net profit margin, return on equity, and return on asset. นะครับ So here is the formula.So if you are interested, to compare the thing, so you need to do 2 years and compare it. This is a basic finance. So in the future, if you like finance, there are a long way to go. You can go to master and PhD degree. But some of you said, oh, I don't like finance. So just do your best at this time. I want to give you a good grade, actually. No worry.นะครับ so นะครับ if you don't like this one no worry นะครับ I didn't have any hard feeling with you นะครับ so you just do it best and you get the good result and you study all the other things นะครับ even if you plan to work in other career นะครับ finish your BBA first and then you go for your dream นะครับ but right now we meet together we have to make it best okay นะครับ so during the break นะครับ I will share you thiscalculation นะครับโอเคนะครับ the first question I got from many of you how you gonna find the financial statement basically we find it from sec.or.th โอเคนะครับ so I see all of your company and I download all of them I put in the Google Drive for you this is how can I assist you นะครับ and then today I will share you this calculation โอเคนะครับ and if you see you need to use consolidate โอเคนะครับ for example CPO they have plenty of subsidiary so consolidate is mean it console all of the subsidiary already โอเคนะครับ here is the financial statement analysis นะครับ in fact there are hundreds of ratio นะครับhow we calculate this thing it will help you to compare your performance of your company นะครับ it will help you to arrive at the understanding of your business นะครับ you compare yourself year on year is that in a good trend is that in a bad trend you compare yourself with your competitors how they do good how you do something better than others okay นะครับ so here is example นะครับI will share it to you นะครับ right away นะครับ during our break okay นะครับ and then I got some additional question นะครับ receivable correction อาจารย์ this is trade account receivable okay so what I would like to let you know is thatWhen you see our example in class, that is a simplified financial statement. Okay, นะครับ But this is a real financial statement. There are hundreds of items. So, account receivable, trade account receivable, trade receivable. You use this one. Okay, นะครับ That is the same thing. Also for payable, you see.อาจารย์ they have auto receivable shall we include that okay นะครับ I got some question like this นะครับ so have a look here I just use line 11 so the question is that shall we use number 12 oh I cannot answer your question you need to go to note okay นะครับ so right now I would like to share you some new informationIf you are interested to see what is the detail of this number, you should have a look on note. And if you see here, you want to understand that, you have a look on note. If you download my financial statement that I provide to you, there will be one file called note. Double click on note. Nah, ครับ And right now, we are interested to understand more about auto receivable. That is number 8. You go to number 8.8 okay นะครับ so let's have a look at number 8 number 8 is where is number 8 number 8 is here you see so what is auto receivable refund from well added tax or VAT withholding tax prepaid expense something so no it is not deal directly with yourmaterial it is not deal directly with your suppliers นะครับ so oh sorry receivable your customer so no need for other receivable okay นะครับ so during the break I will share you this example นะครับ maybe you have a look on your work and maybe you adjust it นะครับokay นะครับAnd one thing is that don't do like this. It is equal to current asset 7703953005 divided by no, นะครับ You should put in a formula. This one divided by this one. That's it. Okay, นะครับ You should put in a formula. นะครับ Remember, นะครับIf you have to make something very difficult, then there will be some easy way to do. นะครับ You see Excel as your assistant. นะครับ It helps you. Okay, นะครับ Right now, I hope you have a clear understanding on the ratio analysis with the real example. นะครับ นะครับ If you have any question, feel free to let me know at any time. นะครับ I am always here to support you. นะครับ I am always here to support you. นะครับI'm very happy when you drop me a message, you ask something, or you ask me for a phone call we can talk นะครับ we can talk นะครับ I'm here for you นะครับ especially business finance I know that it might be difficult for you นะครับ but trust me นะครับ we meet only one time นะครับ and once you finish this one I'm very happy โอเคนะครับ try to make it นะครับ in the best result โอเคนะครับ I will not make a trap for you I will not do somethingthat will do in that way no worry นะครับ so during the break นะครับ I will share you a note this is called note to financial statement นะฮะ someone said why we need a note to financial statement remember นะครับ in financial statement you have only number you don't have any area to provide them an explanation and this is the latest one นะWe didn't study for a case like 20, 30 years ago. This is 2020, just last year. Okay, นะครับ I hope you are all fine, นะครับ I hope this thing make your projects easier, นะครับ If you have any question, feel free to let me know, นะครับ Okay, นะครับ So, some of you asked me, อาจารย์could you repeat the term projects the first term projects once again นะครับ so this term project consists of three parts นะครับ company information financial analysis and finding and recommendation นะครับ you just provide 15 pages of PowerPoint นะครับ and on that presentation day you need to submit to KMTL go on that day นะครับ so this is week 7นะครับ this is week 7We're gonna discuss about the final chapter, the final topic of the ratio analysis. After that, I will introduce time value of money to you. Next week, we're gonna discuss about discounted cash flow, and I will give you a very detailed review of the midterm exam. นะครับ After that, the following week will be midterm. I give you enough time. Basically, I share you.Exam paper on Monday and I ask you to submit on Saturday. Now I give you enough time, no worry. And a week after the midterm will be term project presentation. Okay, นะครับ So next week, another chapter and midterm review. The following week, midterm. The following week, project presentation. Okay, นะครับ So I need no more than 15 pages of PowerPoint.นะครับ I know that you have a lot of work already นะ I will not force you to do too much นะครับ The first part let your friend know about the company in brief นะครับ Company description product and service นะครับ Financial analysis นะครับ You need to conduct a common size นะครับ After that you conduct a ratio analysis for the year 19 and 20นะ You need to do year 19 and you need to do year 20นะครับ If you remember in our Google DriveI give you 2 years in a row. After that, นะครับ provide your recommendation. นะครับ if you see something you want the company to improve, นะครับ you can make a recommendation. And the presentation date will be a week after the midterm exam. Okay, นะครับ that is all about term projects. นะครับ I hope you have a very clear understanding right now. นะครับAnd this example, I hope that it will benefit to you a lot. Even right now in this situation, the economy is very difficult, and the job in the market is quite difficult, but always finance job available. This is what I would like to let you know. So at least we understand about finance. Just understand it. But I can deliver many many topic in term of finance นะครับ for you นะครับ if you are interested in นะครับ we have a lot of advanced topic that you can actually use in the real world นะครับ I studied finance for the first time in 2009นะครับ and I entered to the stock market since then นะครับ so right now it is my 12 years นะครับ in the stock market นะครับI believe I fall in love finance since the first time I study about this นะครับ and then later on it become my job นะครับ thank you so much นะครับ let's move on นะครับ if you have any question feel free to let me know นะครับ so we gonna move on with the topic today นะครับ The topic today is the final part of the racial analysis นะครับThe topic today is the final part of the racial analysis นะครับโอเค The next group will be investment and shareholders โอเคนะครับ The next group will be investment and shareholder นะครับ Why we need to understand thisOh, we are interested to invest in some stock. We would like to know whether that stock is good or not. They provide a good profit or they give us a very good dividend or not. So, ratio analysis based on the investment and shareholder perspective. Basically, they try to look, is that cheap or expensive stock? Is that good for us to buy at this time? Does the company pay a very gooddividend or not okay นะครับ this is how investment and shareholders they try to understand okay นะครับ so we are going to discuss a few of them นะครับ we are going to discuss a few of them นะครับ the first one is the earning per share earning per share okay นะครับ so that is the portion of a company profit allocated to each outstanding shareLet's say that this company, they report 100 million profit. Oh, that is too much. And then this company, they have 100 million share. Okay, nah, hub. So earning per share is mean that you use this one divided by this one. So earning per share, it is equal per 1 baht per share. You see? Okay, nah, hub.How about the next year? For example, the next year their profits become 120. So you use 120 divided by 100. So next year earning per share is 1.2 baht per share. The company do their business better. Okay, นะครับ So earning per share is one of the indicator. If you are interested to invest in a stock, you would like to see whether this company they are in a good in terms of the earning or not. Okay, นะครับ earning, that is the same thing as a net profit. Okay, นะครับ in the finance, there are a lot of name. Earning, net income, net profit, bottom line, all of them refer to the net income. Okay, นะครับ So,Earning per share is one of the indicators that the investor that try to look whether this company have a good profit or not. Okay, นะครับ I show you some example of the calculation. After that, we go to see the real thing is the market today. Okay, นะครับ So this is earning per share. นะครับ We are going to help each other to calculate the earning per share. นะครับEarning per share for Ford Motor, Walmart, Nvidia, and McDonald's. นะครับ So, earning per share, basically we use A and B. Okay, นะครับ So, you use A divided by B. Be careful, นะครับ Billion, 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 million, million.Okay, นะครับ So from now on, I will calculate based on this simple calculator. นะครับ I'm not sure whether you have calculator or not. นะครับ But some of you use mobile phone. นะครับ But anyway, myself, นะครับ I have a financial calculator. But normally, I just use this normal calculator. นะครับ So.We are going to calculate earning per share for Ford Motor together. นะครับ You use A divided by B. นะครับ 1.23 divided by 3.97. So here is your earning per share. 0.309. Okay. What is the unit? ดอลลาร์ per share โอเคนะครับ so basically the investor they look at if I hold this stock they will generate net profit for us per month around 0.3 โอเคนะครับ how about the following one Walmart 13.64 13.64 divided by 3.1 okay 4.4 4.4 okay นะครับ4.4นะครับ the next one Nvidia นะครับ be careful นะ this one is billion this one is million okay นะครับ so 1670 divided by 541นะครับ this is 3.086โอเคนะครับ finally McDonald Corporation นะครับ4690 divided by 854นะครับ so that is 5.49 โอเคนะครับ this is the basic นะครับ earning per share โอเคนะครับ someone said อาจารย์ why we need to calculate this นะครับ let's say this is 2016 and this is 2015นะครับ 0.2 5.1 2.8 4.1 for example so basically what does financial analyst they look basically they're gonna compare year on year you see so from 2015 to 2016 Ford Motor is getting better they report better profit you see how about Walmart for example oh EPS drop oh EPS grow oh EPS grow you see this is how the financial analyst nah they try to look and they try to understand they try to understand about what happened in that year and when you compare with the previous year to see the trend okay nah this is what we call earning per share okay nah some of you have question Ajahn, we know about this how are we going to find this one number of share or share outstanding นะครับอ่ะI will take a photo and I will send in our line group นะsome topic is too complex นะครับ I will not I will let you know นะครับ no worry นะครับอ่ะ some of you have question อาจารย์ how we get this where นะครับ I have a look here so you go to the www.set.or.th okay นะครับ and then let's apply the case of Cinex นะครับ just for the study SYNEX นะ Cinex นะครับ you go to the stock exchange of Thailand website and you go to profile is here นะครับ you scroll down นะครับ here is your number of share you see นะครับ here's number of share okay นะครับ so if you are interested to calculate Cinex you divide it by 847 million shares นะครับ you go to FS and highlight you see they let you know about revenue net profit earning per share okay นะครับ wow earning per share is getting better you see but it's dropped from the previous year you see if you make your own calculation and it didn't equal to this one nah, no worry นะครับ because sometimes in finance we have some adjustment nah, so you base on the financial statement that I provide to you in the Google Drive นะครับ you just have a look on this you might arrive at a similar a different number no worryokay นะครับ you see earning per share okay นะครับ later on we're gonna discuss about this later on โอเคนะครับอ่ะ let's move on together นะครับ the importance of earning per share นะครับ why earning per share is very important นะครับ as I have mentioned to you นะครับ I will calculate the video once again นะครับ16 divided by 541 3.08 This is earning per share นะครับ So the word earning per share is mean that your expectation of the profit per share for each company โอเคนะครับ Basically larger is better So the important of the earning per share is that it break down profit on one share basis นะครับ If you hold one share it mean this amount of profit for the company โอเคนะครับโอเคนะครับ you understand around this นะครับ I'm very very happy นะครับ earning per share นะครับ the next one is the price earning ratio โอเคนะครับ price earning ratio earning per share you see you use earning divided by share right now price per earning what does it mean you use price divided by earning per share โอเคนะครับ you use price divided by earning per share ครับ the first one is the earning per share profit for each particular share but right now they are forecasting whether the price what is the price stock priceThe price that this stock being trade in the stock market. Okay, นะครับ So you need to calculate EPS first and use as a divisor. Okay, นะครับ So it measure its current share price relatively to earning per share. Sometimes we call price multiple. Sometimes we call the earning multiple. Okay, นะครับ In the past, นะครับwhen we go to the midterm นะครับ I ask student to compute price multiple นะครับ they have a lot of question in the class นะครับ what is the price multiple นะครับ I said oh that is just a PE they said อาจารย์ we didn't remember price multiple we remember price earning ratio นะครับ but in our exam นะครับ I will not do that นะ just price earning ratio นะครับ soYou need to look at the share price today and you have to divide it by the earning per share. So it's become a PE ratio. And this is one of the important indicator when you are interested to buy a stock. นะครับ whether the stock is expensive or cheap. Okay, นะครับ So the PE ratio indicate a dollar that you will invest นะครับ compared to the company earning.So, นะครับ if the PE is 20, what does it mean? PE, it is equal to 20. It means this is 20 in terms of price and this is 1, for example. So, you pay $20 for any 1 baht of earning. You see? So, that is the meaning. So, high PE is mean that stock price is expensive. Low PE is mean that stock price is not expensive.โอเคนะครับ here is what we call PE ratio นะครับ after this นะครับ I will show you in the real website of the stock exchange นะครับ in this example I will describe to you and I will ask some of you to help me to calculate it โอเคนะครับ so see this one let's calculate the PE ratio for WalmartAs November when the stock price close at this one. So here is the P, you see, stock price. The company profit during the last four quarter of this one. You see, profit number of share is here. Okay, นะครับ So you need to calculate earning per share first. That is equal to 13.64.billion divided by number of share 3.1 billion What is that number? 13.64 divided by 3.1 4.4 okay นะครับ 4.4 so this one is here 4.4 and right now what is the stock price 91.09 okay นะครับ so I would like some of your help to calculate PE for me ครับ please help me calculate PE ครับ anyone if you calculate that put in our line group นะครับ
20.7
okay very nice นะครับ very nice that is some of our friend นะครับ given solution already 20.7 okay นะครับ thank you so much okay นะครับ so what does it means so it means that this is price per earning so you pay 20.7 for one earning per share 1 baht earning per share okay นะครับ so that is the benefit of the PE ratio so if the stock price go up to 120 for example so you use 120 and divided by 4.4 it will become 27 in terms of PE you see so you say that the stock price is much more expensive right now okay นะครับ that is the benefit of the PE ratio นะครับ so last PE ratio is mean that นะครับ we call over value นะครับ last PE ratio นะ LUE นะครับ last PE ratio นะครับ a high PE ratio is mean over value นะครับ investor are expecting higher earning growth the investor said I buy at expensive price because I believe that the earning will go up so once the earning go up PE goes down okay นะครับ but low PE is mean that it is under value undervalue normal stock in the market they trade PE around 10 or 12 นะครับ so if you see PE like 5 or 6นะครับ it is relatively undervalue นะครับ when the company นะครับ report loss นะครับ PE will put as NA นะครับ it mean that if this one is negative number นะครับ so you will report as an NA okay นะครับ have a look hereIn this company, earning per share is negative. See? So PE, we just say NA. Okay, no need to calculate it. It does not mean anything about earning per share, PE ratio in this case. Okay, let's have a look in our example. Let's have a look in our example.My com is relatively slow right now. นะครับ have a look. Earning per share. What does it mean? You use earning here and divided by number of share. Okay, นะครับ earning divided by number of share. So earning per share for this stock is 3.61. And what is price per earning?You use market price of the stock right now divided by EPS, you will arrive at 24. You see? So here is some example of EPS and PE calculation. Okay, นะครับ You might have a question, how do I get this formula? Actually, you just double click on the cell. It will show you a formula. Okay, นะครับ You see? Go back to the CNET ครับ You see? Earning per share. You see? PE ratio. You see? So the stock price is getting up almost 3 times. PE ratio goes around 2.8 times. You see? นะครับ so when the PE is quite small you say that the company is undervalued นะครับ but right now it is quite expensive already for this stock okay นะครับ I hope that youOnce you understand about the topic we discussed, I encourage you to go to the Stock Exchange of Thailand and try to study about this, try to see the consequence, try to see the data here. นะครับ It might be some first step for you in the stock market. Okay, นะครับ Let's move on.For the next topic, นะครับ no need to be worried, นะฮะ enterprise multiple, นะครับ I will not cover this thing in the exam, นะครับ but just to let you know, enterprise multiple, นะครับ right now I am in the viewpoint of not just an investor, I would like to acquire your company, I would like to buy this company, so basically the one who are going to buy the company, they try to look at the enterprise value.So we use the enterprise multiple or EBITDA multiple นะครับ to judge whether a potential acquirer นะครับ to how much they see the company value. So what does acquirer mean? I will buy that company. So once you buy that company, you buy the company and you have to bring debt with you. Okay, นะครับ because you buy that company already, you have to.Responsible for that debt, their obligation. So enterprise multiple, the formula is that you use enterprise value divided by EBITDA. Okay, นะครับ enterprise value divided by EBITDA. Enterprise value, นะครับ it is based on this formula, นะครับ market capitalization, นะครับ market capitalization means number of stock multiplied by the price plus preferred share plus minority interestplus debt minus total cash no worry on this topic นะครับ just for your knowledge for this one นะครับ EV measure company value นะครับ some of the people I ask them in the question paper นะ describe about EV in the company they said electric vehicle นะครับ oh that is not about our subject นะครับ soนะครับ when I am interested to acquire some company I will look at their enterprise value because when I buy that company they need to come up with debt as well so here is a formula of the EV นะครับ number 1 number 2 and number 3นะครับ it consists of three things 1 plus 2 minus 3 if you multiply this one together you will arrive at market capitalization okay นะครับ number of share multiplied by share priceYou plus debt and you minus cash. So here is your company EV, นะครับ company enterprise value, นะครับ for this topic just for your knowledge, นะครับ And then the next one is EBITDA. What does EBITDA mean? Earning before interest, tax, depreciation, and amortization, นะครับ When they look at EBITDA enterprise multiple, นะครับ the formula is thatThey use enterprise value divided by EBITDA. Okay, นะครับ So, นะครับ They use EV divided by EBITDA, and here is the EBITDA. Okay, นะครับ A low ratio indicate that undervalue. High ratio is mean that company overvalue. Okay, นะครับ But you need to compare with the same company in the industry. This is what we call enterprise multiple. Okay, นะครับno need to worry about this topic นะครับ here is the enterprise value okay นะฮะ market value plus your debt minus your cash here นะครับ EBITDA นะครับ you just use EBIT plus depreciation so here is your enterprise multiple or EV per EBITDA นะครับ just that okay นะครับFinally, in this topic, นะครับ it is not too difficult, นะครับ we are going to discuss on dividend yield, นะครับ I invest in some stock. What I would like to gain is that by the end of each year, the company will give us money that is called dividend. In Thai we say เงินปันผล okay นะครับ so the dividend yield indicate how much a company pay for you so what is the formula this is also important นะครับ annual dividend divided by price per share let's assume that you get $7 in term of dividend and that time stock price is 84 so what is the dividend yield นะครับYou use 7 divided by 84 multiplied by 108 นะครับ 0.3% This is the dividend yield If you bring your money and you put in the bank they give you an interest but if you buy a stock and company report profit every year they give you dividend In Thai we say เงินปันผล Okay นะครับ So here is the dividend yield นะครับ How much a company pay out in dividend to you? Okay, นะครับ So here is the company called PTTGC, and here is the last price in the here is the last price in term of the end of last year 85, นะครับ So dividend yield นะครับ divided by 85, นะครับ Last year, this is the information.Record on the dividend นะครับ On 18 September they pay to you 1.75 On 25th of April they pay to you 1.8 So what is the dividend yield ครับ 1.8 plus 1.75 multiply by 100% ครับ So here is the dividend yield นะครับ What is it 1.8Plus 1.75 divided by 85, 4.12%. You see? Okay, นะครับ This is what we call dividend yield. นะครับ dividend yield. Okay, นะครับ So in term of the dividend yield, you need annual dividend. It means that if you are interested to calculate for the year 17, you have to use.The dividend that pay to you on year 17, all of the dividend that pay to you in the year 17. Okay, นะครับ Right now, นะครับ I hope that you have a very good understanding on this, นะครับ We have another topic called ratio analysis, นะครับOkay, นะครับ let's have a short break, นะครับ After that, นะครับ we are going to come back and continue the last part of the ratio analysis as well as new material, นะครับ That is what we call time value of money, นะครับ I'm sure that is going to be a very interesting topic and help you a lot in term of finance, นะครับ Today our class is a little bit long, นะครับโอเคนะครับ after a short break we come back and we discuss on the ratio analysis the last one profitability not too difficult โอเคนะครับ so let's have just 10 minutes break นะครับ right now is 1:50 come back at 2 p.m. นะครับ and we have a long discussion after that if you have any question feel free to let me know นะครับ take care everyoneOkay, นะครับ Welcome back, นะครับ I hope you have a good short break, นะครับ and ready to move on with our class, นะครับ Okay, นะครับ during the short break, นะครับ I share you the example that I let you know, นะครับ you can see in our like group.นะครับ so the first file is the financial analysis นะครับ the second file is the note to financial statement and then the third one is the calculation template for the next chapter okay นะครับ let's continue with the remaining topics นะครับ and everyone นะครับ welcome to the last topic about ratio analysis นะครับโอเคนะครับ Welcome to the last topic about racial analysis นะครับI hope that oh there be some delay wait a moment นะครับโอเค I see some lag from my laptop นะครับ so นะครับ I hope that example นะครับ provide you some guideline นะครับ but if you have any question feel free to let me know at any time นะครับ from now on นะครับ ladies and gentlemen นะครับ welcome you to the last group of the racial analysis นะครับ right now we are interested to understand the profitability of the companyนะครับ profitability นะครับ whether the company produce a good profit or not โอเคนะครับ this is the last นะครับ group of the ratio analysis นะครับ so นะครับ whether the company report a good profit or whether they report a poor profit นะครับ so let's move on นะครับ and this is the ratio analysis นะครับThe last group of the ratio we call profitability. We try to understand about the profitability of the company. They try to assess a business ability to generate earning. To generate earning. So basically profitability นะครับ in Thai ความสามารถในการทำกำไรนะครับ A B นะครับI will ask you นะครับ I will not explain anything to you first นะครับ I will ask you นะครับ we have two company A and company B นะครับ I just let you know that company A have 8% profit company B has 12% profit I ask you ครับ I didn't give you any concept นะครับWhich one is better ครับ let me know in the like group นะครับ please everyone นะครับ any idea there are plenty of the ratio to let you know about the profit but right now hey company A 8% company B 12% okay higher is better or lower is betterOkay, นะครับ so in terms of the profit we love larger profit that's why later on นะครับ all of these number larger is better นะโอเคนะครับโอเคนะครับ your answer นะครับ makes me feel energized นะครับ feel of the energy นะครับ thank you ใบบัว arm off นะครับโอเคองศานะครับปุ่นนะครับMonday F Jane James Burn Free Milk นะครับ Kate DD Yelly จ๋าแอนอุเป้นะครับ Thank you so much นะครับโอเคนะครับ So from now on keep in your mind that all of the ratio that we discussed they are all about profit larger is better okay นะครับLarger is better. When we would like to assess a company profitability, we can assess them in several indicator. Okay, นะครับ So you need to be able to compute this one, and this one. นะครับ No worry on this one. Some of them they are too complex at this level. นะครับ Profit is an absolute number. นะครับ Profit is an absolute number. So the unitIs, for example, 100 million baht. That is the profit. Okay, นะครับ that is a profit, and that is a company objective to make a profit. นะครับ if the company they cannot report profit, it means they are loss. Okay, นะครับ so this is a profit, but this is a profitability. ความสามารถในการทำกำไรนะครับ it is a relative numbers.So it will represent to you in percent, for example. Okay, นะครับ So in this topic, we are going to discuss about what we call profitability. now profitability. In terms of the profitability, we can understand the company operation in several aspects. Do they manage a good cost of goods sold? Do they manage too much expense? Something like that. Okay, now let's move on. The first one is a gross profit margin. Gross profit margin. What does gross profit margins mean? From now on, gross profit margin is mean that you use gross profit divided by sales. Okay, นะครับ sales revenue they are the same. So the gross profit is mean you use gross profit divided by sales. And what is gross profit? Sale minus cost of goods sold or cost of sale, just that. Okay, นะครับ So I would like to show you this example, have a look here. This is a gross profit margin. You use revenue. Let's have a look here first. This is your gross profit. You use revenue minus cost of goods sold. You will arrive gross profit. So gross profit deduct just cost of goods sold. Okay, นะครับ have a look here นะครับ it is equal to revenue minus cost of goods sold just that so this company report 2994 million baht in term of the gross profit in term of the gross profit margin is mean that you use gross profit divided by revenue okay นะครับ this is a gross profitSo gross profit try to assess the performance of the cost of goods sold only. Okay, นะครับ So you remember numbers of 59, นะครับ if the cost of goods sold become 3,000, what happened? Gross profit margin dropped to 40%. Okay, นะครับ So if you manage cost of goods sold efficiently,Gross profit margin will be high. Okay, นะครับ If you report, for example, on that year you cannot control cost well, นะครับ You see, gross profit margin drop a lot. After that, นะครับ you report a negative income. Okay, นะครับOkay, นะครับ I hope that you have a clear understanding on gross profit, นะครับ Okay, let's move on, นะครับ So gross profit, they focus only on the cost of goods sold only, นะครับ So they didn't take into account of all related expense after that, okay, นะครับ So if the gross profit margin 45% if this mean that every $1 of your sale make 45 point of the gross profit นะครับ every 1 baht of your revenue will be 0.45 baht in term of the gross profit นะครับ basically this indicator they focus on the core business how they manage cost most of the manufacturer they have to control the gross profit because that is the indicator of the manufacturer นะครับOkay, นะครับ this is a gross profit. Then the next one, นะครับ much more easier, นะครับ net profit margin. If you see net profit margin, it mean that you have to divide net profit with sales. So, นะครับ you look at the net income. At this time, this is a company performance. Okay, นะครับ net profit is the bottom line.So at this time, net profit, it represents the overall performance of the company. You use the bottom line divided by the revenue. Okay, นะครับ So it report about the company performance. It report about the company financial health. Okay, นะครับ So, นะครับ here is the example of the calculation, นะครับLet's have a look here. The thing that you need is the total revenue minus cost of goods sold. This is a gross profit, you see? gross profit. And once you deduct all the expense, you arrive at the net income. Okay, นะครับ So gross profit, you use this one divided by this one, you will arrive this number. And in terms of the net profit, you use this one divided by this one, you arrive at net profit margin. Okay, นะครับ Gross profit ratio, gross profit margin, they are the same. Net profit ratio, net profit margin, they are the same. Okay, นะครับ No worry about this one. Okay. What I would like to let you know is that นะครับ in the finance นะครับ we have plenty of the indicators นะครับ and basically when I sit as a financial analyst in the company I try to make an analysis on this and I try to bring out some issues for all company to do นะครับ for example CFO this year we have a better gross margin.It means that we control the cost of production very well, but we report lower net profit margin because we have too high interest expense, for example, you see. So inside the number is the calculation. After the calculation is the insight, นะครับ how you're gonna interpret those story. Okay, นะครับ Let's have a look in our example.นะครับ our example นะครับ right now you see net profit margin you use net income divided by revenue that's it okay นะครับ gross margin net profit margin okay นะครับI love when some of you send me your work or you ask something for me to clarify, right? Because that means you try to apply it in your real thing. Right? And I would like that finance, when you study in the university or when you go to work, that is the same thing. Right? That is the same thing. When I work in the organization, I also work like this. Right? Okay, nah?I hope that this calculation will help you นะครับ Let's have a look in the scenic case นะครับ scenic case นะฮะ scenic case you see gross profit margin when you see something like this it means it linked to this sheet นะครับYeah, like this, นะครับ it linked to the PL. PL is profit and loss. นะครับ this is the net profit margin, and we are going to calculate ROE and ROA later on. Okay, นะครับ I provide any example for you. นะครับ if you need more support, feel free to let me know. นะ I'm always here. นะครับ And one thing I would like to let you know is that I look forward to meet you in class, นะครับ นะครับ I hope the situation will getting better. Okay. We understand about the gross profit margin, นะครับ We understand about the net profit margin, นะครับ The remaining one gonna be return on equity and return on asset.นะครับ return on equity is mean that you use return divided by equity just that you use net income divided by equity how much profit a company generate with the money of shareholder invest you see so you just ROE it represent return in term over the equity partAnd then later on, ROA is mean net income over the asset, just that. Okay, นะครับ So both of these two guys, you use net income divided by equity and net income divided by asset. นะครับ In the real business, นะครับ they call ROE and ROA. Okay, นะครับ for this thing, นะครับ no need to worry. DuPont will come back later on after the midterm. นะครับ So from now on, ROE is mean that you are interested to assess the profitability over equity. If the equity owner invests a lot but you report a very poor profit, so ROE will be very low. Okay, and in terms of the ROA, if you invest in a lot of assets and the net income is very low, it means ROA will be very low. Okay, just that at this level, no worry on that, on all the issues. So let's have a look in our example before we come back. Here, you see. Bangkok Airways. Okay. So from now on, we are going to calculate return on equity. How to do that? Return on equity. What you need to do, you just use net income divided by common stock and retained earning. Actually, this one, it is equal to equity. This one is equal to equity. This point is very important. Some of you asked me a question, Ajahn. We see this item in this simplified financial statement. When we see the real one, sometimes they use different name. What I would like to let you know is that in our financial term, there are plenty of name. As I told you, account payable, trade payable, other trade, account payable, something like that. But after the long-term debt, all of the item here before total, they are equity. They are equity. If you get some confused, drop me a message. I will solve that for you. ROE, what is that? You use net income divided by equity. You use net income divided by equity. And how about the ROA? You use net income divided by total asset. When you think about the ROA, it means that you use net income divided by total asset. I hope you are all fine. Okay. The next one, we are going to discuss some case study before we finish off this topic now. When you are interested to compare between the two companies, let's say that, right now we are working in AirAsia and we would like to compare ourselves with Bangkok Airways. This is an example, maybe company A and company B, but A and B. Make sure that A and B, they are in the same industry. Prepare with your mobile phone. In terms of the gross profit margin, please let me know which one is better. This is the real life. Which one is better, in terms of the gross profit margin? Which one is better? Give me your answer in our like group. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Okay. Wonderful. I love when you participate with me. I know that this subject is difficult. And I heard from maybe from the previous group. They don't like this. They hate this. Don't think like that. Just come to study together. If you don't like this subject, I wouldn't force you to like this subject. But to move together and to pass this subject, that is a goal. Thank you so much, Bai Bua Kanji. jelly arm นะครับอุ่น f t เคสองศาขิงจ๋านะครับmilk may pupe and jane นะครับ thank you so much นะครับ so in term of the gross profit margin b is better นะครับ in term of the net profit margin a is better you see in term of the return of equity a is better in term of the return on asset b is better you seeSo in real life, if you compare between the two company, นะครับ company B manage their cost of goods sold very well. But company A manage overall profit very well. You see. So if you stand at company A, you need to have a look how does company A B arrive at better gross profit.You tend to compare with your comparable. Okay, นะครับ How about the return on equity? A is better. See? How about return on asset? B is better. Okay, นะครับ This is the last thing on this topic. นะครับ It is not just calculation. You need to think aboutComparison in term of company A and company B, for example. Okay, นะครับ Thank you so much, everyone, for your participation. นะครับ I'm very happy to talk to you. นะครับ Okay, นะครับ Okay, นะครับ Thank you so much for your participation. นะครับSo let's finalize this long chapter together นะครับ for Dupont นะครับ no worry at this stage นะครับ we come back later on about Dupont นะครับ so right now I hope that you have a clear understanding on ROE and ROA already นะครับ let's move on let's evaluateROA for the three company in the retail industry นะครับ in the retail industry นะครับ so we are going to calculate the ROA นะ ROA some of you ask me why we need ROA นะครับ some company there some business they are very capital intensive it means they need to invest in a large asset นะครับ so ROA is very importantSo let's calculate ROA together. นะครับ you use net income divided by total asset. นะครับ you use net income divided by total asset. นะครับ be careful นะครับ this is million and this is billion นะ be careful นะครับ billion is thousand million. Okay นะครับ we are going to calculate this thing.Even I work in finance, นะครับ I still have this normal calculator, นะครับ Sometimes it is easier than the real financial calculator, นะครับ Financial calculator is very huge, นะครับ and it needs a lot of technique to do, นะครับ Let's go with the small calculator, นะครับ611 divided by 19850 multiplied by 100So the ROA is 3.07% นะครับ The next one is JCPenney นะครับ 1 million divided by 9310 multiplied by 100 0.01% 0.01%In term of the share, นะครับ minus 2 billion, นะครับ it lost a lot นะ share, นะครับ 2.22 divided by 9.3, นะครับ multiply by 100, it mean minus 23.7%, นะครับ it indicate company performance okay นะครับ have a look on some example you see if you go to the stock market as I show you นะครับ stock exchange of Thailand you will see this number นะครับ ROA ROE and net profit margin นะครับ they provide net profit margin for you they didn't provide gross profit margin okay นะครับThank you so much นะครับ for your participation in this chapter นะครับ I hope that we all learn a lot together นะครับ I hope that you see some benefit from this thing นะครับ In the real organization we still work on the calculation like this นะครับ From now on นะครับ Let us conclude this chapter นะครับWe talk about the financial. In the previous chapter, we talk about the financial statement. นะครับ In this chapter, we talk about the financial ratio. okay, นะครับ Financial statement is like this. You see, every year they publish this number. นะครับ But there are a lot of inside calculation. นะครับ Inside calculation. If youUnhigh นะฮะ there are several financial statement นะครับ for example statement of change in equity นะครับ statement of นะครับ cash flow นะครับ in the advanced finance นะครับ we have a lot of calculation around this นะครับ that will bring some insight for the company okay นะครับ but right now we focus some important group of the financial ratio okay นะครับAll right. If you have any question, let me know. Nah. Actually, there have lot of the ratio. Nah, ครับ But this is the basic finance course. Nah, ครับ I don't want to push too much. Nah, ครับ But anyway, we understand all of the concept. Nah, ครับ Right now, nah, ครับ Please welcome, nah, ครับ To the next chapter. Nah, ครับ To the next chapter. Nah, ครับThe next chapter is a chapter on what we call time value of money นะครับ time value of money นะครับ when the time has passed นะครับ the money change their value โอเคนะครับ change their value นะครับ so I share you this calculation template นะครับ we are going to utilize this thing นะครับ throughout this chapter นะครับ time value of moneyนะครับอ่ะ let's move on นะครับ the first picture นะครับ time value of money นะครับ the important things in this chapter is that the money นะ they change value over a period of time โอเคนะครับ soTime value of money. Sometimes they use the word TVM, time value of money. I would like to give you some example of from my experience. นะครับ when I was young, นะครับ Coca-Cola for one can is 10 baht. When I was a teenager, 12 baht. When I begin my career, 14 baht. And right now is around 16 baht.Maybe in the next 10 years, it's become 20 baht, you see? So, the value of the money is getting less นะครับ day by day. นะครับ It's getting less day by day. นะครับ So that's why, นะครับ the time value, the time, they have some effect on the value of money. Okay, นะครับ In the first picture,นะครับ is very important นะครับ and I will describe this thing to you นะครับอ่ะ let me adjust a little bit นะครับ I have more space to write นะครับอ่ะ everyone นะครับ have a look carefully on this page นะครับ Mr. Vasu นะครับ oh I have 100 baht นะครับOh, I put in the bank. The bank told me that, Basu, we give you 2% interest. Every year, นะ, 2% interest. นะครับ, 2% interest. 2% interest. นะครับ. I put the money in the bank and then in the next year, this money will become 102. Okay, นะครับ. Why?Because I put 100 in the bank, I put it for 1 year, I get interest 2 baht. Okay, นะครับ? 100, you get 2 baht. You move on to the next year. You didn't bring those money out. You get another 2%. Okay, นะครับ? So, instead of 102, นะครับ, you will get... 104.04. Okay, นะครับ That is 2% interest over this amount of money. Oh, no, no, no. I will not withdraw. I put it another year. So, นะครับ Multiply by 1.02. I will have 106.12. You see?It is like you save your money when you were young, and every year they give you interest, dok bia. So, in our time value of money, we can say that this amount of money is equal to this amount of money in the different year.Okay, now in the different year. So we call this thing as the present value. Present value is mean now. It's mean now. Because you invest, because you put 100 in the bank. Okay, now that is the present value. That is the present value. Here is the what we call future value, and future value. Okay, now.So, how you compute this one? Multiply by 1.02, okay? Multiply by 1.02. 0.02 is your interest. Multiply by 1.02. Okay, นะครับ. So, right now, what we calculate here is mean that we are going to calculate present value intofuture value okay นะครับ so someone might tell you hey Basu 100 it is equal to 106.12 which is correct but it is in a different period of time this is a present value this is a future value and future value okay นะครับ the way you move forward นะครับ we say compound นะครับ compound นะครับ compoundCompounding. The first one is compounding. Okay, นะครับ. We have the second example. นะครับ. Someone might ask, Wasu, I would like to have 106.12 at year 4. How we should invest right now? So, you begin with 106.12.And you put it back here, นะครับ. So if you move forward, you multiply. If you move backward, you need to divide. So you divide by 1.02. You will arrive at 104.04. You're gonna discount it back to year 2. You divided by 1.02. What does 1.02 mean? It means 1 plus your interest 2%.Okay, นะครับ it's become 102 and you divided by 1.02 you arrive at 100นะครับ so the second one we call discount นะครับ discount นะครับ discount okay นะครับ so compound is mean that you calculate present value to future value and the word discount is mean you discount the future back to present value. Okay, นะครับ so this is the basic concept that I would like to let you know. นะครับ you need to metaphor it easy like you put 100 baht in the bank every year they give you 2% interest. Okay, นะครับ if some of you have your calculator นะครับ or you use your mobile phone calculator นะครับ mobile phone calculator นี่นะครับ this one or this one นะครับ you can do it นะครับyou calculate with me you calculate with me นะbefore I forget นะครับ I put in our line group นะโอเคโอ้ no Wasu we oh what happened to my โอเคนะครับ right now the bank said Wasu we give you 3% what happened นะครับ so calculate with me นะครับ100 is gonna be 103 okayAfter that, you use 103 multiplied by 1.03. You will get 106.09. Multiplied by 1.03, you will get 109.27. Okay, นะครับ I would like to metaphor like you get interest from the bank. That's it.This is a concept of time value of money. When the time change, the value of the same amount of money has changed. Okay, so before we move on to the following slide, present value is now. You want to calculate the future value, we call compound. But if you have a future value, you want to date back to present value,we say discount okay นะครับ this is the time value of money at the beginning นะ if you can understand this นะครับ it's very good but if you cannot if you need some more explanation นะครับ inside the chapter there will be a lot of explanation นะครับ this is just to make you familiar with this thing okay นะครับ let's move on time value of moneyWhen the time has passed, นะครับ the value of the money they change, นะครับ so this is the most important idea for this class, นะครับ a dollar received today is worth more than a dollar received in the future. So in the real organization, นะครับ when you conduct your business, นะครับ you need to think about the cash flow, นะครับ the cash flow, the early cash flow, we have more value thanthe cash flow at the same amount นะครับ many years ago นะครับ so a dollar received today is worth more than a dollar received in the future I ask you one question use your understanding Okay, นะครับ we are going to do some small class activity นะครับ hey everyone someone gonna give us 1 million baht okay นะครับ we have two choice the first choice we receive 1 million baht now the second choice we receive 1 million baht 3 years from nowWhich one is your choice ครับ A or B ครับ Let me know Someone gonna give us 1 million Put in our line group นะครับ Someone is gonna give us 1 million They give us two choice Choice A They give us today Choice B They give us 3 years from now 1 million which choice you will choose ครับwhich choice which choice ครับ Wasu, we have a choice for you. You receive 1 million today or you receive 1 million 3 years from now. Okay. Thank you so much นะครับ Fari, Kate, Kanji, Jelly, F นะครับ Arm, DD, Bonfree นะครับ James, Jane, Milk, Un นะครับ Thank you so much นะครับจ๋ามันเดย์ทีนะครับ Thank you so much ปูเป้นะครับ You see Everyone choose A No one choose B โอเคนะครับ Why I receive 1 million from nowAt least I put in the bank, I get interest. Or maybe I invest in other investment and I get more benefit. Why I need to wait for the next 3 years and I will get that money? And moreover, they might not follow the commitment. They might not give us 1 million. Moreover, 1 million from now, I can invest.I can get interest and more value, you see. There are a lot of idea in your head. If that doesn't follow that commitment, they just close the company away and we didn't give you money. So a dollar today worth more than the future. Okay, นะครับ The sooner your money can earn interest, the faster interest can earn interest. It means interest on interest.You get interest, you put in the bank, they give you more interest. So that is the concept of time value of money. Later on, นะครับ, we will see that there are three rationale behind this thing. Why everyone we need to accept now. Okay, นะครับ. Thank you so much for all of your participation. นะครับ. So, นะครับ, welcome you to this chapter officially, นะครับBenefit and cost, they are all about money. They usually occur at different point in time. Okay, นะครับ So, 1 million today, 1 million for the next three years, there are difference in terms of the value. So, we need to make it consistent. Okay, นะครับ We need to make it comparable. Okay, นะครับ This slide, no worry. นะครับ This slide, no worry. So,Time value of money นะครับ100บาท now worth more than 100บาท at some time in the future so why all of you told me that you choose A to receive 1 million now maybe there are some uncertainty or risks they might not give that 1 million to me next 3 years they might break the commitmentMonetary inflation. Oh, we receive 1 million today. We are going to invest in some investment and we gain some profit. Why we neglect that? And finally, personal consumption preference. Someone might think that, oh, we receive 1 million. We're going to use that today. See? So that's why that is the rationale behind why you think that.1 million you should receive it today okay นะครับ so that is the rationale behind that thing okay นะครับ so right now I hope you see that the value of the money นะครับ they change from time to time they change from time to time and that is the core idea okay นะครับ today we gonna discuss about the concept and next week I will show you some practical examplesIt helps us to make a decision a lot. Okay, นะครับ So, I will show you about this example, นะครับ Very important, นะครับ Very, very important. And I will introduce to you how we're going to use this calculation template, นะครับ This is very important, นะครับ Have a look here.On the left side is one man, นะครับ and then this is indicate on what we call present value, นะครับ The word present value is mean now. this man put $1,000นะครับ in some investment and then those investment tell him that you will get 10% return every year นะครับ every year it might be an interest it might be some money top up on the investment นะครับ so they ask youWhat is gonna be in the next 5 years? What is gonna be in the next 25 years? So, this is a time value of money case. This is a present value, and this is a future value at year 5, and this is a future value at year 25, you see. So right now, that is the interest 10% per year.So what is the value about this and what is the value here? You see, the man is getting older and become a grandpa in this picture. Okay, นะครับ So I will show you นะครับ how to calculate it. So right now it means that you know present value and you are interested to calculate future value. So here present value and here future value. นะครับYou know present value already. You see, I put a note for you. You know the present value and you are interested to calculate the future value. Use this one. Or compounding present value to future value. Okay, นะครับ So right now, hey, I invest 1,000 at a number of period in the next 25 years. And they commit for the return for 10%. You see?So right now, if you invest 1,000 and they have returned to you 10% per year in the next 25 years, 1,000 will be 10,834. Okay, นะครับ So the ways that you calculate, the way that you calculate here and here is what we call future value calculation. It helps you a lot. Na. In the future, next week I show you example. If you are going to buy a life insurance and then you pay money to them and then they will get back to you some money at the end of the contract, you can use this calculation to think whether that is good to you or not.Okay, นะครับ So this is a future value calculation we call compounding. Okay, นะครับ So 1,000 it is equal to 1,600 and it is equal to 10,000 but in a different year. Okay, นะครับ So you must be clear today, นะครับWhat happened in the next 5 years? You just replace this one to number 5. You see, this number and this number, they are equal together. Okay, นะครับ So this is what we call future value calculation. You try to calculate the money that you're going to have in that future. Okay, นะครับ If you scroll to the left side, this is the present value calculation. Okay, นะครับThe question is like this. In the next 25 years, you listen to my case carefully. In the next 25 years, I would like to have $10,834.71 for my kids. How much should I invest now? Okay, นะครับ So the story, they let you know about the future value and then they ask you about the present value.You know about the future value. You are interested to calculate the present value. Okay, นะครับ So the process that you need to do is what we call discounting. นะครับ It's called discounting. นะครับ So what you need to do, นะครับ You need to input 108.34.71. Number of period 25. You see 25 years.And discount rate. Now, some of you might have a question. What is discount rate? Later on, I will show it to you. นะครับ10% so we should invest 1,000 today see here is the discounting so you need to input the number in the yellow cell and the present value and the future value will help you to calculate automatically okay นะครับ maybe you need to digest this math นะครับ mathนะครับ mathematics นะครับ after this class โอเคนะครับ future value present value calculation นะครับ here นะครับ so here is the present value calculation you know future value you are interested to calculate present value นะครับ future value calculation is mean you know present value and you are interested to calculate the future value โอเคนะครับmaybe you need to play these numbers นะครับ after the class นะครับ in the next 5 years you are interested to have 1,600.51 you see you need to invest 1,000 now okay นะครับokay นะครับ I hope you are all fine นะครับLet's move on นะครับ so here is what we call time value of money นะครับ in term of time value money นะครับ in the future we can add on to more advanced topic นะครับ next week you're gonna see what we call DCF discounted cash flow นะครับ I work a lot in the DCF นะครับ in the company in the consulting projects นะครับ so basic definition นะครับ present valuenะครับ earlier money on the timeline นะครับ so what is the timeline what is the timeline นะครับ here นะครับ this is year 0 year 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 for example so here is the present value is mean now นะครับ and the later on นะครับ we callfuture value in year 1 future value in year 2 onward until future value in year 7 okay นะครับ present value and future value and then นะครับ every year that you get interest นะครับ they have a few key terms that can be used interchangeable for example interest rate discount rate cost of capital opportunity cost required rateนะครับ we're gonna discuss about that later on นะครับ but right now if you see the discount rate in that นะครับ make sure that that is same thing as the interest นะครับ it is same thing as your return that you would like to have นะครับ just remember in this way before นะครับwe're gonna discuss about this thing นะครับ discount is the process of reducing cash flow to present valuenะครับ and compounding นะครับ if you remember about these two keywords นะครับ discounting is mean you do future value to present value นะครับ and the compounding is mean you calculate present value to future value นะครับ just to definition นะครับnext week we are going to continue thisCalculation นะครับ but I would like to show you some example first นะครับlet's have a look here นะครับ I show you some example นะครับ after that นะครับ we can finish off นะครับ have a look here okay you practice with me นะครับBecause when I share you and a material I share you solution already นะ I share you solution already นะครับ it is around 10 example นะครับ so let's have a look on the first one นะครับ suppose you invest 1,000 for 1 year at 5% per year what is the future value in 1 year what is the future valueThis one, no. This one, yes. Future value calculation. Okay, นะครับ You invest 1,000. Okay, นะครับ You put a number. You input 1,000. number of period 1 year and your interest is 5%. So the future value will be 1050. Okay, now first of all, you need to ask yourself whether they ask for future value or present value. So here is the present or future. They ask you about the future value. So you need to find out from this. Okay, now maybe you need to digest this map after the class. But one thing you need to think about yourself, they ask me present value or future value. Okay, now the second example, suppose you invest 1,000 for 1 year. Suppose you leave your money for another year. What does it mean? You leave 1 year and you leave it another year. So it means 2 years. Okay, so you change this number into number two. So this is your future value 2 years from now. Okay, maybe you need to have a look and read the case carefully. Suppose you invest 1,000 for 1 year at 5%. What is the future value in 1 year? That is example number one. Suppose you live for another year. You see, you live 1 year and you live another year. So this number is number two. Okay, The third example, suppose you invest 1,000 from the previous example for 5 years. So instead of 2 years, you put 5 years. So here is your future value. Okay, so here is the present value and future value calculation. So what I would like you to do is that you have a look in the example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Have a look on this. And then you can also see solution. When I send it to you, I give you a solution as well. Have a look here. Example one, invest for 1 year. You see, you put 1,000. Interest is 5%. So the future value is 1,050. In the second example, you put it for 2 years. So it means that you multiply by 105 and multiply by 105 two times. We use power. But in my calculation template, I calculate for you already. How about invest for 5 years? You replace by power 5, you will arrive at the same number. Okay, next week, we are going to discuss case study number 4, 5, and 6. Maybe you can read on that prior to the class. Okay, maybe time value of money is the new topic to you. So this is an important thing because for example you are going to invest in the life insurance policy. And they ask you to pay 30,000. And the end of the contract, they give you back a money. Is that good to you? We are going to analyze that next week. It helps you a lot when you are going to invest in some insurance policy. Kromathan Pakan Chivit. That is some example. Actually, time value of money is also very important for all of the finance people. We discussed about the time value of money. We discussed about the concept, why we need to understand about this. We need to discuss about some reason that you told me that you would love to get 1 million now, not next 3 years. We discussed about this concept. Maybe you need to sit and digest this mathematics. What is the present value? Present value is the current period. So 5 years from now is the future value. 25 years from now, that is the future value. โอเคนะครับ next week we are going to drill down into more detail นะครับ into more detail